Hey, welcome to my channel. I'm T, and I'll be your host for today. Okay, just kidding. But I'm here because I want to tell some stories today. Well, a story today. And today, the story will be about why I chose online college instead of in-person college. Follow me. So this all started when I was a young kid. LOL. So basically, growing up, I always wanted to go to college in person. Dorms, parties, the full nine. That was the goal for myself. And that was also a goal that my mother had for me, right? So my whole life, I was just like, gotta go to college, gotta go to college, gotta go to college, gotta go to college, right? But, college is expensive. That was always something, that my mother knew, that I knew as well. So she always tried to push me to do good things, I guess, like getting good grades and stuff. Ha, that never happened. No, just kidding. I did get decent, average grades, obviously. Well, there's no obviously. You don't know me. I got average grades. I'm an average person. Let's just establish that right now. Basically, I was just an average student. And I'll say I was specifically average in high school. Like middle school, blowing it out the water. Elementary school, easy as pie, because those are all just usually really easy. But high school specifically, I was very average. And that was the only time that I guess I needed to not be average. But high school was really hard. I was suffering. It was a terrible time for me, and my grades took the hit as well as my mental health. So middle school's fine, having a great time or whatever, passing, doing great. And then I get to high school. So I want to say something about my high school. My high school was a magnet school. It was specific for this thing. It was a high school and college, right? So I got some college credits while in high school, which at the time when I was finding high schools, it was the best thing possible. I was like, yeah, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna get in, and I'm gonna just, kind of kill two birds with one stone, save some money for college, and this is gonna be a good thing for me, It was and it wasn't. It was like a toss-up, actually. Got to high school and I don't know, I was just really sad. I guess it could have been definitely depression. Like my grades took a hit, like a hit from Mike Tyson. Like they were getting punched every time I just, just I breathed. And Mike was punching down on my grades. I mean, I know it's not Mike's fault, but they were bad. Well, like I said, they weren't bad. They were average. And I wasn't used to that at that point. So I'm looking at my grades and I'm like, wow, I'm really average. These are not looking good. And it was just, from what I was already sad about, it was just like all going, the grades, the sanity, I guess. Not sanity. I was sane, but I was really sad. So the happiness, I guess that's more appropriate. The happiness, the grades. The happiness, the grades. And I was almost subpar. Almost subpar. I was. I have to tell you, I was almost subpar. So, my grades are really average, almost subpar, and I'm just like, wow, I'm not gonna get a scholarship to any college. Am I even gonna get into college? No. I'm gonna tell you my stats. They're not great or whatever. And take into account that I did go to a magnet school that was high school and college, and I think at first I was ready, and then I let everything mess me up. So then I guess I wasn't really ready. But so basically I had 2.5, which is really average, but my school was actually not like an average school. So I was literally like in the fourth percentile. I was at one of the bottom of the class. It was so sad. I wanted to cry every day, right? And I 2.5, I took some AP classes. I also had the college classes, so I think that helped me with some of my college applications maybe. And I got accepted into like three colleges. The three colleges were University of Memphis, Southern Illinois University, and the University of Denver, Colorado. Now, okay, so with UCD, University of Denver, Colorado.
Correction, University of Colorado, Denver.
That was my first choice, and I really wanted to go there, but it was very expensive, and like I said, with average grades, no one's giving you a scholarship. Well, I don't want to say that. Apply for scholarships, even if you don't think you'll get them. I personally was also very sad, so I was like, oh, I'm never going to get these scholarships. I applied to like 4 scholarships at the beginning of my junior year, and no more. That was it for me. I didn't get those. I was sad, and it just wasn't it anymore. So like I said, I was like, I got no scholarships. I was really sad, and I was like, oh my gosh, like, how am I gonna go to college? I'm gonna have to take out a lot of loans. And my one thing was, is like, not one thing, I was talking to my aunt, and she has a channel too, I'll get below, but basically, like, she was telling me, you know, about her college experience, and I'm just like, okay. And then, like, we were talking about loans and stuff like that, and I'm like, do I want to take out that many loans? Like, do I want to take out loans at all? Like, I don't want to start my adult life in debt, you know? So initially I was gonna go to Southern Illinois, but then I looked at the demographics, and like, I didn't know if I would like fit in there. Like, I kind of got scared. So I was like, okay, looks like University of Memphis is the best place for me. So I was gonna go, and you know, I had did all the stuff, you know, fill out for the dorms and stuff. And I was looking, I was like, oh my gosh, this is not expensive as Denver, but this is a pretty big loan, you know, when I have to take it out. And I was like, okay. So I'm like, okay, this is a pretty big loan, but like, my mom's gonna help me take it out. So like, yeah. But then I waited to take the loans out, so I couldn't. I didn't have many options for loans. Like, school was like a month away. I didn't have a job. Like, and my mother, she was gonna help me, but at the same time, she had other loans, so I didn't know. Like, the situation was really like kind of messed up. So I was like, okay, I have to push this back to another year, which really, like, it really threw me off. But I didn't think they were gonna take the college credits that I already had either, so I was like, okay, it's most likely gonna be 4 years, and I'm gonna have to take out a loan each year to pay that off, unless I like work through college, which is already a lot. Like, I wasn't even working in high school, so I was like, maybe if high school was so hard and I didn't even have a job, maybe I should like think about job in a college. Like, a job in a college, how much stress that would add for me. So yeah, I was like, that's a lot of stress. That seems like a lot of stress, especially for like people who like already have a lot of stress with college. So I was like, okay, I'll push it back to another year, and I'll try to save up some money. So I got a job, and I saved up some money. Now, the thing is, that money, I saved up, I guess, $1,300. That's what I saved up. And $1,300 is a lot. Like, I guess on a regular basis or whatever, but for a college loan, that's not putting a dent in anything. It's not enough. And I was like, okay, this is not it. This is not enough. Like, it's not enough. So I'm like, this is not enough. I don't think I'm gonna even go to college. Like, I don't think I'm going. anymore. Like, I'm not going there. And I was like really sad. Like I said, I feel like failure. College was always the goal. Like in-person college, I'll say that. In-person college was always the goal, like for me, right? I'm like, oh my gosh, like I just felt terrible. I felt like trash. But then my mom was like, hey, like some college options, and like my employer pays for the tuition. Like they help you pay for the tuition assistance. I'm like, okay, I'll look into that. Cause even though like in-person college was the goal, I still wanted a higher education. I still wanted a college degree, right? So I'm like, okay, I'll look into that. So I looked into the colleges and I'm like, okay, they don't seem bad. Like obviously they don't have as many options as like an in-person college would, or like a campus college. And I was like, okay. So I originally wanted to study, well, I was gonna study international studies with a minor in Chinese. I took Chinese for 4 years in high school. I regressed sadly because no one to practice with. Like I do plan on continuing to study Chinese, like obviously. Well, I keep saying obviously. Not obviously, but I plan to continue studying Chinese. Like one of my goals in life is to be a polyglot. So yeah, I plan on studying Chinese more. Obviously. But yes, I'm like, okay. Yeah, I'll look at, you know, their catalog and see what they offer, and you know, try to find the best thing for me. So eventually, I don't know if I can say the college that I'm about to start. I'm about to start it like in March. So I don't know if I can say it, but I guess I'm trying, like I'm getting over it. Cause you know, online college is usually for like older people who like have full-time jobs. Like, well, not usually, I don't want to say usually, but a lot of older people who like have kids and husbands and wives and partners, they have full-time jobs, and you know, obviously they can't go like live on campus. So they do it online, which is cool. But I don't have kids, don't have a job. So I was still kind of like iffy about it. I was like, wow, like why? Like you're not doing nothing. Well, you're not doing anything. Go to campus. Go to the campus. But then as I said, it was still in my head like, they're really trying to make people be in debt forever. And I was like, okay, no, you know, get over yourself. Get over that feeling of having to be on a campus. Cause you know, you don't have to be on a campus. You don't have to be. You saving money and your mother's employer is gonna help you pay. So get over it. So I had to force myself to get over it. And now I'm gonna go to online college because it's cheaper. And basically like, you know, it's cheaper. All around it's cheaper. I'm still staying with my mother. And I don't pay rent. I know not everyone like has the luxury to like live with their parents and not pay rent, but I was blessed and lucky enough to not have to pay rent, you know, not really have the responsibility of bills right now, and till I, you know, achieve the degree. But yeah, but all in all, I think this is probably the best option for me. You know, cheaper. And I think I can, you know, find myself. What I will say is that since I stay in my state, I don't really have like things to do, so it's like I'm always at home. I have a couple friends, but I don't have like a lot of friends. I don't have any place to go. So that's kind of a downfall for my social life. But I'm going to try to, you know, network and stuff like that. Find my way into places. Find my way into certain spaces to, you know, make connections and things like that. But right now, this is a good option. And I think that it's gonna work out. Or I don't want to say think. It's gonna work out. Manifestation. Manifestation. So if you liked this story time, or it's not really a story time, just a me going on about, I guess, my journey. Like, I feel like story times are more like actually set. There's a timeline. This was just me kind of just going on. But if you liked this video, or if you thought this video was helpful just a little bit, or if you were entertained or just informed, like, comment, subscribe if you want to. And yeah, have a nice day. We out.